हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स। मीटिंग अगेन विथ अ न्यू रेमेडी एंड अगेन अ प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द रेमेडी। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग रेमेडी, आई वांट टू शेयर माय फादर्स केस विथ ऑल ऑफ यू। इनफैक्ट आई हैव ट्रीटेड हिम विथ सेम रेमेडी नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स सिंस लास्ट 10-15 ईयर्स। आई एम यूजिंग इट वेन एवर इट इज नेसेसरी। What happens, he generally have a little bit suffocating feeling in the chest, and there was only one symptom. In fact, it is not a symptom, it was a sign, because I used to examine his pulse and BP, and whenever I used to check his pulse, there are always misbeats at every third or fifth or seventh, or sometimes every 10th beat. He used to have misbeats, and in fact for that purpose he has investigated a lot, but nothing happens. Everything was fine, normal. Even echocardiogram was normal, ECG was normal. He was seen by certain cardiologist, DM cardiologist, and they said that it's a functional, because we cannot come to the conclusion of anything. But he used to get along with that little bit suffocation or weakness, that was his symptom. So earlier, when I was the younger one, I was knowing that he was having this typical pulse, but I don't have a daring to prescribe the digitalis at that time, because the thought was very different in my mind. And that's why what happens whenever we are young, there is always a fear in our mind, because we learn the homeopathy in colleges, the theoretical homeopathy in colleges. And in theoretical homeopathy, whenever we used to learn, we used to learn homeopathic aggravation, medicinal aggravation, and all those terminologies. And there is always fright in our mind that whether if we give a remedy and if it aggravates the condition, if it is related with the heart, what will happen? Our concepts are not clear at that time, and that's why we fear to prescribe. Because whenever we are prescribing any remedy in the dynamic form, it will not going to cause any pathological problem. So you can safely use your remedies if given in potentized form, you can safely use without causing any harm to the patient. It will not going to produce any harm. So that concept was not there, and that's why I used to fear, or there was a fright in my mind. But later on, when I understood all those concepts clearly, I used digitalis to him, and with few doses of digitalis, next day I have checked his pulse, and it was quite in a rhythm, and it remained for in rhythm for years together. Again, the 2-3 years back, he had the similar complaints, and at that time his angiography was done. There was a little bit block, and it was decided to go for an operation. Angioplasty it was done, but still this problem persists, that he had a misbeats. So again, I have decided to give him a digitalis, and I have prescribed digitalis 30 for 2-3 days tedious. And after giving that, within 2-3 days, his pulse again came into the rhythm, and it remained in rhythm. So this is very important aspect. These are the things which one should not forget. Generally, what happens, so, being a number of homeopaths, never clinically examine the patient. They take the verbal case taking and prescribes. This is very wrong method. In fact, you have to check each and every patient. You take the pulse, they take the blood pressure, auscultate the patient, if necessary, the abdomen, etc., check for all those things. So clinical examination is very important thing, which guides you a number of times towards the right remedy. So after giving digitalis, he recovered so fast, and now he is running 83, and still he's having very good heart. So we have ample remedies which acts on the heart, having a lot of pathologies, and we are not using it only because we don't have an ICU setups. In fact, this is one remedy according to the pathological state. this remedy is very important remedy in circulatory failure. Basically, it is congestive cardiac failure. And that's why, because of congestive cardiac failure, whenever there is a renal insufficiency, producing a renal pathology or renal failure secondary to the heart, the digitalis is one of the important remedies. Number of times there are sometimes patient complains to you hot flushes in the head, that is another condition. Sometimes the patient complains of vertigo. Sometimes patient complains that there is something which happens in my chest. I feel that my heart has stopped. Such types of sensations generally which comes with this remedy. And that's why it is better to go with the Alan's keynotes to understand remedy. He has explained the pathological aspect very nicely in the form of keynotes. So digitalis is a foxglove. It is from the Scrofulaceae family. Second important thing which I want to share with you, same remedy which is used in allopathy, the same principle, digoxin. The common brand name is Lanoxin, which contains digoxin, is nothing but the digitalis. And they are using it for the heart complaints. They are using it to maintain the pulse rate. If there is a flutter or severe tachycardia, to control that, the same remedy is used. And we can use the same remedy in the similar manner. So only thing is that we have to understand what it produces at the functional level. So what he says, sudden flushes of it followed by great nervous weakness and irregular intermittent pulse. Underline this, irregular intermittent pulse. This is very important. Occurring at climacteric. This is another thing. Occurring at climacteric. So climacteric age remedy. Lachesis number one, sanguinaria canadensis number two. This is third one, one should not forget. Aggravated by least motion. So sudden flushes of it, aggravated by least motion, one should not forget. These are things which are very important. Then second sentence which he uses, weak heart without valvular complications. So there are, it is not remedy for valvular troubles. Adonis vernalis is the remedy for valvular heart troubles. Naja is the remedy. We have discussed earlier. Naja is the valvular heart remedy. This remedy doesn't have a valvular troubles, but it has a weak heart, a cardiomyopathy. And that's why this remedy works better in such conditions where you get a weak heart. Sensation as if heart would stop beating if she moved. So if a patient walks, they feel that heart will stop. That is the feeling, because generally in weak cardiac muscles, post myocardial infarction, cardiomyopathy can occur. And in such types of patients, similar types of sensations often develop. This, if this sensation persists, this is number one characteristic feature of the patient. Cocaine is another remedy having the similar symptom. Then gelsemium, where exactly opposite is there. What is there? Fears that unless constantly on move, heart will cease beating. Gelsemium love ulta vart. Gelsemium feels that if they stop walking, heart will stop. This is the exact opposite to the digitalis. Faintness and sinking at the stomach. What is faintness? Means gheri yana. Dola puda andhari yata. Faintness. Why this is? This is because of circulatory failure. The sinking in stomach, again, one of the feature of the circulatory failure. Exhaustion and extreme prostration, that is the result where the circulatory failure happens. Feels as if he were dying. So that is another feature, that because of the weak heart, they feel like that they are dying. Nightly emissions with great weakness of the genitals after coitus. So it is also a remedy in the males where there is a nightly involuntary emissions of the semen with great weakness of the genitals. Specifically after the coition, if it happens to be there, digitalis is one of the remedy which you can think of. Great weakness of the chest, cannot bear to talk, like sternum. Sternum is a remedy where you get a tremendous weakness, and that's why they fear to talk. Whenever they are talking, they get breathless, they get aggravated. That is sternum metallicum. So severe prostration, sternum is one remedy. Here it is severe prostration because of the heart weakness, the cardiomyopathy, and that's why they speak less. Stools, very light, ash colored, that is very important feature. Delayed, chalky, like chelidonium and podophyllum. almost white like calcarea, cinchona, pipe stem stool, and involuntary. Sometimes it is involuntary. This happens, involuntary stools happens in circulatory failure. If patient is in sudden shock and patient can get a typical involuntary stool. Now, the most important feature which is given in bold that you should underline, pulse is full, irregular, very slow and weak, intermitting every third, fifth and seventh beat. And this is the characteristic of the remedy. The characteristic, and that's why you must have a habit of taking the pulse, you can get the remedy. Face is pale, death-like appearance and bluish red because there is less blood supply, the outflow is less, and that's why the patient's face becomes absolutely pale, death-like. Bluishness of the skin, eyelids, lips, tongue, it is typical, a cyanosis, and cyanosis is the result of circulatory failure. See, correlate the pathology. Then you can understand this is the patient of a digitalis. You can catch it very easily if such types of features are there. So cyanosis is the result of circulatory failure. Circulatory failure is the result of cardiomyopathy. Cardiomyopathy is the result of post-myocardial infarction commonly. So these are the things which you can correlate with the remedy. Distended veins on the lids, lips, ears, and tongue. Because of passive congestion. When veins are distended, this indicates that CPVC, chronic passive venous congestion. Because of congestive cardiac failure, the back pressure increases, veins become turbid. Respiration is irregular, difficult, deep and sighing. What is sighing? Sighing manje husasa takna. There is a habit of certain persons like doing this. If it happens involuntarily without any reason, it is ignatia. Patient enters in our clinic. He came on the on his vehicle, just enters in your clinic and he sits in front of you and he does as if he is walking 5 kilometers. This itself suggests that this type of sighing is the ignatia sign. That is not related with any pathology. But if it is associated with the heart pathology, where congestive cardiac failure is the result, always think of the digitalis. So respiration is irregular, difficult, and deep sighing. Dropsy. Dropsy means generalized edema. How these dropsies? Post-scarlatina. So it is because of the failure, because of the scarlatina, a fever with rash which has been suppressed, leading to a dropsy, renal failure. So this is very important, post-scarlatina, in a Bright's disease. So here, Bright's disease is secondary to the heart complaints. Bright's disease is a very important thing, that is, it is glomerulonephritis. But this glomerulonephritis, which happens to be there in digitalis, is secondary to the congestive cardiac failure. It is not primarily a Bright's disease, which happens to be there in Apis mellifica or Aposino. These are the remedies where you can get a Bright's disease directly. Here, it is secondary to it. Then what he explains, in Bright's disease, with suppression of urine, so urine output becomes less. Of internal and external, dropsy of internal and external parts. So dropsy, internal parts means ascites you can get. Dropsy or external parts, you can find it over the extremities. Dropsy with the fainting, where there are no organic affections of the heart. So you can find it out, patient don't have any organic affections. Organic affections means he is having valvular heart trouble or all those things are not there. It is clearly a failure of a musculature. Heart is not able to. It is a weak heart which is responsible to produce a dropsy. And that is the congestive cardiac failure which you can see over there. So, dropsy with soreness in the uterine region is convallaria majus. That is a different entity. So, that doesn't come in the comparison part over here. Last symptom of this remedy is very important. Fetal syncope may occur when being raised to upright position. Patient is lying down, he is good, and when he is upright, immediately the blood pressure falls down. What is it called as? it is a positional hypotension which develops, and sometimes because of circulatory failure, if patient becomes upright position, there is sudden fall in a blood pressure, patient can go into the syncope, and that syncope can lead to a death also. So this is a typical remedy where the heart is at a fault, where heart is having a failure because of a cardiomyopathy. This remedy is the basic remedy in your hand. You give it in potentized form, and you can get the results with the 30 potency. Even 6 potency is a good potency to be utilized in case. My suggestion is that don't go for mother tinctures, because if you give the mother tinctures, you don't know what exactly it will going to produce its primary action. So whenever heart condition is there, always better and safe to give a potentized remedy. I will suggest 6 or even 12C or 30. These are the potencies which you can use, and you can use basically in a repeated doses also twice a day. Relation synchrona antidotes the direct action of digitalis and increases the anxiety. So synchrona is the antidotal directly to the digitalis. And second, it increases the anxiety, because the anxiety increases because of the already the patient is congestive cardiac failure, your remedy is not working. If you would have given synchrona, the patient's digitalis action is getting antidoted, and patient again goes into the heart conditions, and because of which the palpitations, and because of which the same thing, he develops the anxiety over there. Aggravation when sitting. Because in sitting position, the blood pressure falls, especially when sitting erect. So that is because of hypotension. And aggravation by motion, same thing. Since congestive cardiac failure, if a patient walks, the breathlessness is the result, because deoxygenation happens over there. And that's why a fainting is there. So this is a good remedy to be utilized in ICCU, intensive cardiac care units. This is a good remedy whenever your patient, you feel patient pulse is small, hard, and sometimes you are finding it out that it is irregular, missing beats every third, fifth, seven beats. Don't forget the digitalis. And if you get, typically, if you are a good clinician and diagnose that this is a case of congestive cardiac failure, think of the digitalis first. So clinical understanding of the remedy gives you and guides you to the practical solution. And that's why my suggestion is that always read the medicine thoroughly. Understand the medicine. If you understand medicine properly, then you can prescribe right remedy to the patient. So thank you very much for attending session. Amit, Sindhu, thanks a lot. We'll meet again tomorrow if time permits, and we'll continue with one more remedy. Till that period, thank you. Share the videos with your friends. Ask your friends to join or subscribe our channel so that they can learn regarding all those practical remedies. Thank you once again.